Hello, my name is Derek Goltz. Today I'm gonna teach you, walk you through how to time in from start to finish a F40 filler. This filler, in for instance, has quite a few set of change parts, so I will show you what it takes to time in a filler from start to finish, starting with your first set and ending with your last set. So the first thing you want to do is collect all of your star wheel parts. You have your in-feed, transfer, discharge, capper. So all four of them are sitting here. The first thing you want to do is you want to make sure that your bolts in the star wheels themselves are in the middle of adjustments. So you've got one here, and one here. And as you can tell, they're all in the middle. That will help you in setting your master timing and all of your parts moving forward. As you can see, this is not adjusted properly. To adjust this, you'll need to adjust this 5/16 bolt and adjust it into the middle before starting your timing process. So one thing I wanted to point out is when you're timing in a filler, everything on this machine you can time is adjustable except the bowl. So everything you do has to revolve around the bowl. The bowl is locked in place. Everything else has to be timed around it. So that's why you start at the in-feed star wheel. You work your way backwards to the screw. Once you verify that this timing is correct, you jog the bottle around to the transfer star wheel, which is adjustable. From the transfer star wheel, you go into the capper. You make your adjustments in the capper. After the capper, you bring them into the discharge star wheel, and then you make your adjustments in the discharge star wheel. I want to talk about the two different types of timing that are on these fillers. You have master timing and you have change part timing. So your master timing is done here at the hub. So in, for instance, this filler, being an F40, has a 1.5-inch nut that holds the hub down in place. So this is your master timing. This will be done on the initial first set of change parts you have will be set by your master timing. After that, you will use your change parts to adjust timing, which is very fine-tuned timing. Your master timing will set your timing as a good starting point for your second set of change parts. But for your first set, all of your timing will be done with this master timing here. So the first thing you want to do after you install your change parts is you'll want to put a bottle in the in-feed star wheel, and then you'll want to jog it forward towards the bowl. Clear! You want to put the bottle right at tangent. Now tangent is if you were to draw a line from the center of this star wheel to the center of the bowl column. This is where you'll find most of your adjustments will be needed. So what you'll want to do from here is if you jog that bottle up there and your timing doesn't look right, you're going to take your wrench, your 1.5-inch wrench, put it on your master timing. You're going to loosen this master timing, make your adjustments needed on the star wheel, and then tighten your timing back down. Tighten this 1.5-inch nut back down. Note that we are not changing any of the timing on the star wheel itself, only the master timing for this first set. So after you've made this adjustment and tightened this nut down, you'll want to take the bottle and jog it up to the bowl a few times to verify that you like the timing. After you like the timing, you verified, you know, half a dozen times, you're going to want to make sure that this nut here is tight. After the nut is tight, your master timing on your in-feed star wheel is set. So it's important to have the conveyor chain running when you're timing the screw. The chain will actually pull the bottle forward into the screw. As you can see right here, if the chain is not running, the bottle will ride in the back of a screw. With the chain running, it pulls it into the forward of the flight, and that will give you a more realistic production style running set. After your in-feed star wheel is timed, you'll want to come back to your screw, and there are four set screws, two on the in-feed and two on the discharge. You'll need to loosen the set screws before timing the screw. Next, you'll want to take a bottle, set it in between your infeed star wheel and your screw. Verify that your screw is not pinching the bottle or forcing it forward or back. You want this bottle to be directly in the middle of this star wheel. Once you like your timing of this screw, you go ahead and tighten your screw down. Next, you want to verify that you like the timing between your infeed screw and your infeed star wheel. Next, you'll want to jog some bottles around the back side of the bowl and bring them up to your transfer star wheel. Again, we're only, for our first set, we're only timing in our master timing, which is this big 1.5-inch nut here. So you'll want to take this, loosen it, and then jog some bottles in. Placing this bottle, again at tangent, which is the center line between this star wheel and the bowl column. And then you'll make your adjustments as needed with the master timing. Once you make your adjustments, take your wrench, tighten down your master timing. You'll want to make sure that this bowl guide is adjusted correctly. In order to do that, you loosen these three bolts here. And then you'll want to place a couple bottles in place, and you'll want to adjust these so you're only leaving about a 1/16 of an inch gap, because you don't want these guides to be touching the bottle, but you want them to be there just as support in case the bottle decides to get away from you. And you go ahead and tighten these bolts up. So after you've verified that your transfer star wheel timing is correct to the bowl, then you can move on to the capper. We have set our capper star wheel in the middle of adjustments before we even started. So you'll want to take a bottle, jog it into the capper, and if needed, you'll need to adjust timing in the entire capper. So the same thing as your master timing for the star wheels, your master timing for your capper is actually down here for this particular capper. This is a 700 series capper on an F40 filler. So this capper timing, your master timing, is done down here. This is what's called a taper lock, which is taking a tapered shaft and pulling a lock up into it, locking it in place. So once you jog a bottle in there and you notice your timing is off, we know that the timing of the star wheels is in the middle of adjustment. You'll need to adjust your master timing for your capper, which will adjust your entire timing of the capper. Star wheels, bottom plate, star wheels, spindles, it'll move everything. So you'll make that adjustment down here. After you like that timing, you'll lock it down in place. So once you've verified that all of the timing is correct, you'll want to tighten all of these bolts. There's six of them around this hub, this taper lock. You want to tighten all six of these bolts down in a star pattern to lock your capper back down. So now that you've verified that your capper is picking up the bottle correctly according to your change parts, if your timing is off between your spindle and bottle, you can adjust that by these bolts on the inner here, up here on the top of the capper. There should be six of these as well. You'll want to loosen these six bolts, and that will time your spindles independent from the bottom half of the capper. So you'll loosen those bolts and you'll be able to move the timing of the spindles and line it up with the bottle. So next you'll want to set your outer guides on your capper. In order to do that, you'll want to loosen these two bolts and these two bolts here. So the purpose of these outer guides is to support the bottle as the cap is being applied. So as you're applying the cap, it's taking torsion and the bottle's gonna wanna twist. So you're gonna wanna set these guides so that they're secure to the bottle, but not so tight that they're damaging the bottle. But you wanna make sure that this bottle doesn't twist as the cap is being applied. So in order to do that, you'll loosen these, you'll push this in, you'll figure out where you want it, and you'll tighten these bolts back down. All right, now that you've verified your capper timing is correct, we can go into the discharge. So you'll want to loosen your 1.5-inch nut for your master timing and your discharge star wheel. You'll want to jog a bottle at tangent in between your capper column and your discharge star wheel column. Once you have a bottle at tangent, you will make your adjustments as needed in your discharge star wheel. After you like where your timing is at, you will go ahead and tighten down your master timing. Now that you've made all your necessary adjustments, timing-wise, from your infeed all the way through to your discharge, you'll want to run one bottle through to verify that you like your timing before running production. Moving forward, we have our master timing set already from the previous blue set. Moving forward, we do not adjust timing on the master timing nut. That stays. And the only timing we will do moving forward is from the 5/16 bolts down here. You loosen them, you have a very fine-tuned adjustment, but the timing will be close because the master timing is set from the previous set. Again, this is a video on how to demonstrate to properly time in an F40 filler with a 700 series capper. This is starting from master set for your first set and change part timing for all additional sets. Thanks for watching.